मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, चैप्टर 3, टिश्यू लेवल ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द एनिमल टिश्यूज एंड द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एनिमल टिश्यूज, दैट इज द एपिथेलियल टिश्यू, कनेक्टिव टिश्यू, मसल टिश्यू एंड न्यूरल टिश्यू. So in the last class, that is Kingdom Animalia, we have discussed about the different levels of organization, that is the cellular level of organization, in which the body of the organisms is made up of only cells. And next is the tissue level of organization, in which the body of the organisms is made up of tissues. And next the organ level of organization, in which the body of the organism is made up of organs. And finally, the organ system level of organization, and it is the advanced level of organization. Here the body is made up of different organ systems, such as the respiratory system, excretory system, circulatory system, etc. So the cells, if you take the cells, the cells are made up of biomolecules, and the biomolecules are made up of molecules, and the molecules are made up of atoms. So atom is the smallest unit which cannot be divisible into any part. So the smallest part or the indivisible part is the atom. The atoms combine to form molecules, and the molecules combine to form the biomolecules, such as the lipids, nucleic acid, proteins, etc. And the biomolecules only forms the cells. So cell is the structural and functional unit of all living organisms. The cells combine or group together to form the tissues, that is similar type of cells which are similar in structure and functions group together to form the tissues, and the tissues group together to form the organs, and organs group together to form the organ system. So this is the level of organization. And in this topic, we are going to learn about the classification of or different types of animal tissues. So if you take the multicellular organisms, cells do not operate independently. Instead, they form tight cell communities that live and work together. Individual body cells are specialized, with each type performing specific functions that helps to maintain homeostasis. Homeostasis means it is normal functioning of the body is called as homeostasis, and benefits the body as a whole. So what do you mean by tissues? Means group of cells that are similar in structure and perform common or related functions are called as tissues. So tissues means tissues or group of cells that are similar in structure and functions. If you take the tissues, they are organized in specific proportions and patterns to form the organs. So the tissues organized together to form different organs, such as lungs, heart, stomach, kidneys, ovaries, testes, etc. So all these organs are made up of tissues. Hence the tissues are called as the living fabrics. And if two or more organs perform common physical and chemical functions, they are called as organ systems. So, organs which are similar in structure and functions, when grouped together, they form the organ systems. Example of organ systems are digestive system, respiratory system, circulatory system, excretory system, etc. Most organs contain different types of tissues, and their arrangement determines the organ structure and functions. So the study of tissues, is called as histology. Histology means it is the study of tissues. Animal tissues. So we are going to learn about the animal tissues. Animal tissues are classified according to the size, shape, and functions of the cells. So the animal cells, the animal tissues are classified based on the size, shape, and functions of the cells. So if you take the animal tissues, there are four primary tissue types that interweave to form the fabric of the body. So the animal tissues are classified into four types. They are the epithelial tissues and connective tissue, muscle tissue, and nervous tissue. So there are four types of animal tissues. They are epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue, and neural tissue. So the main function of the epithelial tissue is covering. It covers the whole body. And the main function of the connective tissue is support. It gives support to the body. And the main function of the muscle tissue is movement. So it aids in movement. And the main function of the nervous tissues, it controls and coordinates the whole body. So these are the four different types of animal tissues. First, we'll see about the epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue is a sheet of cells. So if you take the epithelial tissue, it is a sheet of cells that covers the body surface or lines the body cavity. So the epithelial tissue only covers the whole body. So it acts as a cover and protects the whole body. It occurs in the body as a covering, as a lining epithelium, and as glandular epithelium. So mainly the epithelial tissue covers the whole body. The function, the main function of the epithelial tissue includes protection. It helps in protection, absorption, filtration, excretion, secretion, and sensory reception. So these are the main functions of the epithelial tissue. And based on that, structural modification of cells, the epithelial tissues are again classified into five types. They are the squamous epithelium. So the epithelial tissues are again classified into squamous epithelium, so based on the structural modification of the cells, the epithelial tissues are broadly classified into two categories. One is simple epithelium and another one is compound epithelium. So the epithelial tissues are broadly classified into simple epithelium and compound epithelium. Again, the simple epithelium is classified into squamous epithelium, cuboidal epithelium, columnar epithelium, ciliated epithelium, and pseudostratified epithelium. So these are the classification of the simple epithelium. So simple epithelium is again classified into squamous, cuboidal, columnar, ciliated, and pseudostratified.
The simple epithelium is composed of a single layer of cells. Why the name simple epithelium means it is composed of a single layer of cells where they are found in the organs. Where they are found means they are found in the organs of absorption, secretion and filtration. So these are found in the organs of absorption, secretion and filtration. So we have already learned that the simple epithelium is classified into squamous epithelium, cuboidal epithelium, columnar epithelium, ciliated epithelium and pseudostratified epithelium. First we'll learn about the squamous epithelium. So if you take the squamous epithelium, it is made up of a single thin layer of flattened cells. So the squamous epithelium is made up of single thin layer of flattened cells. So the cells are flat with irregular boundaries. So they don't have a regular boundaries, they have a irregular boundaries. So these type of epithelium are found in the kidney glomeruli, air sacs of lungs, heart, that is lining of heart, blood vessels and lymphatic vessels. And they are involved in functions like forming a diffusion boundary and filtration in sites where protection is not important. So the simple squamous epithelium. So in this picture you can able to see the different types of epithelial tissues. And first we are learning the simple epithelium. So the simple epithelium, first one is the squamous epithelium. So here you can able to see the squamous epithelium, that is simple, it is called as simple squamous epithelium. Here it is made up of a single thin layer of flattened cells with irregular boundaries. And they are found in the kidney glomeruli, air sacs of lungs, lining of heart, blood vessels and lymphatic vessels, and are mainly involved in functions like forming a diffusion boundary and filtration in sites where protection is not important. Next we'll go to the simple cuboidal epithelium. So the cuboidal epithelium, it is made up of a single layer of cube-like cells. If you see the cells, they are cube-like cells. So they are named cuboidal epithelium. Why the name cuboidal epithelium means? They are cube-like cells. And the cuboidal epithelium is made up of a single layer of cube-like cells. This tissue, so where this type of tissues you can able to see means it is found in the kidney tubules, ducts and secretory portions of small glands and surface of the ovary. And the main functions of this epithelium, that is the cuboidal epithelium, or secretion and absorption. So this is the main function of the cuboidal epithelium. So cuboidal epithelium means they are single layer of cube-like cells and their main function is secretion and absorption. Next is the simple columnar epithelium. So the name column itself, the columnar epithelium is composed of a single layer of tall cells. Why the name columnar epithelium means? They are single layer of tall cells with round to oval nuclei at the base. So the base of these cells, round to oval shaped nuclei are present. It lines the digestive tract from the stomach to the rectum. So where this type of columnar epithelium are found means, it mainly lines the digestive tract from the stomach to the rectum. The two modifications of this lining are the presence of microvilli on the apical surface of the absorptive cells and goblet cells which secretes the protective lubricating mucus. So the two modifications of the columnar epithelium are lining, that is the presence of microvilli on the apical surface of the absorptive cells and the goblet cells. So the main function of the goblet cells, it secretes the protective lubricating mucus. So the goblet cells only
secretes the mucus. The function of the epithelium includes absorption, secretion of mucus, enzymes and other substances. So these are the main functions of the columnar epithelium. And again, if the columnar epithelium bears cilia, it is called as ciliated epithelium. So if the columnar epithelium, if the columnar cells bear cilia on their free surface, cilia means a very small hair-like structures. So if cilia is present, means they are called as ciliated epithelium. The ciliated type propels mucus by ciliary actions and it lines the small bronchioles, fallopian tubes and uterus. Where this type of ciliated epithelium are present, means they are present in the small bronchioles, fallopian tubes and uterus. Non-ciliated type lines most of the digestive tract, gallbladder and secretory ducts of the gland. So the non-ciliated types, where they are found, means they are found on the digestive tract, gallbladder and secretory ducts of the glands. Next is the pseudo-stratified ciliated columnar epithelium. So it is the pseudo-stratified epithelial cells. So these cells are columnar but unequal in size. Although the epithelium is single layered, yet it appears to be multi-layered because the nuclei lie at different levels in different cells. So why the name pseudo-stratified epithelial cells means, even though the epithelium is a single layer, it appears as a multi-layer because of the location of the nucleus. So the nucleus is located in different levels in different cells. Hence, it is called a pseudo-stratified epithelium. And the functions of the pseudo-stratified epithelium are protection, secretion and absorption. The ciliated forms lines the trachea. So this epithelium lines the trachea and the upper respiratory tract. And the pseudo-stratified is of two types. One is ciliated and another one is non-ciliated. The non-ciliated forms lines the epididymis. That is epididymis means it is the present inside the testes, large ducts of the glands and tracts of the male urethra. So where this non-ciliated forms are present means it lines the epididymis, large ducts of the glands and tracts of the male urethra. So in this chapter, first we have seen about the epithelial tissues and we have also seen the two broad categories of the epithelial tissue, that is the simple epithelium and the compound epithelium. And again, the simple epithelium, it is again classified into, that is squamous, cuboidal, columnar, ciliated and pseudo stratified. So till this we conclude our topic. Thank you.